So, Rob, President Trump was clearly watching Biden's speech as he was flying to El Paso, right? He saw it on television. He tweeted that he was watching Sleepy Joe Biden making a speech. So boring. The lamestream media will die in the ratings and clicks with this guy. It will be over for them, not to mention our country will do very poorly with him. Okay. Should he just have stayed focused on his day and what he was doing and ignored Joe Biden?
Well, let me turn that around. Shouldn't the media, and more importantly, shouldn't the Democrats and the leading candidate right now in the Democratic field, Joe Biden, who should know better, shouldn't they, for a period of time, not go on the attack, not fan the flames, not bring out things like white segregationists and white nationalists and supremacists and all this stuff while the president is going to the two cities that were affected, meeting with family members? Do you think the family members want to hear this nonsense from Beto O'Rourke and all these other candidates who are doing everything political and nothing to actually heal what they're going through? They're ready to bury their loved ones. And the Democrats are fundraising off this. They're calling them a white supremacist. Joe Biden, of all people, brings up George Wallace, whom he received an award from in the 1970s. I mean, there is a period of time. You want to have these fights, that's fine. But this is a period where we should actually put the swords down and talk to the victims and care about them. Imagine if it were turned around. Seriously, just for a second. If Obama or any other president were going to a place where we needed healing and the Republicans started all this kind of nonsense, what would the reaction be? They would be attacking Republicans in the media. Right? Come on, Keith.
What can you say to what Rob just said?
You can say you agree.
Can say that it's utter nonsense. I'm tired of having this discussion over and over again. We all know that Donald Trump is responsible for fanning the flames.
Oh, and pulling the trigger, as they've said? Is that correct? Well, literally, Beto O'Rourke, before the last body hit the ground, was sitting there saying, boom, Donald Trump pulled the trigger. And so were so many other Democrats. I mean, it is so out of bounds, and nobody even cares about that anymore. That's the norm now?
So, Keith, Biden did...
Are you finished?
I'll go on,
I want to play something for you, Keith, but go ahead and respond.
Today, the president of the United States, within the past 24 hours, has attacked Beto O'Rourke. He's attacked the Ohio
Senate. He's responding to
Are you going to let me speak?
But go ahead.
He's attacked Beto O'Rourke.
Who called him what?
Are you going to let
me speak? White supremacist in the White House.
How do you create unity in a country when you have people who are working on behalf of Trump or speaking on behalf of Trump, Rob, who refuse to have a civil conversation, but instead want to turn everything around to somebody else and don't want to address the issue? We're talking about the president of the United States. We're not talking about what other people do or say about the president. Barack Obama spent 5.5 years while a billionaire from New York lied about his birth certificate. And he didn't go on TV every day or on Twitter every day and complain about it. He tried to be presidential. He brought the nation up. This guy brings us down.
As I said, he spent all day attacking people. I'm going to be the president today. Two Democrats in Ohio just said the victims were glad to see me and that they were glad I came.
Keith just made my point. Shouldn't we be respectful? Yes, and it should have started with all the Democratic candidates who Elizabeth Warren sent out a letter fundraising off this.
Donald Trump released a campaign ad today about his visit to Dayton. That's what's despicable. It was a campaign ad.
It was a video of what he
Rob, you know, I don't even know what to think of what you're saying right now because it's all lies. Let me just finish my list that I couldn't finish while you were doing your filibuster earlier today. The senator from Ohio, Sherrod Brown, the mayor of Dayton, Nan Whaley, Bernie Sanders, Beto O'Rourke, Elizabeth Warren, Shepard Smith, Fox News, the New York Times, the quote-unquote lamestream media, and CNN. Those are the people who Donald Trump attacked just today on Twitter while he's supposed to be trying to unify the country after 31 people were shot and killed in El Paso and Dayton. And you are going to sit here and tell me that the Democrats are responsible and not the president of the United States. Where does the buck stop, Rob? I'm sick of having this conversation with you over and over again. You know better. This is ridiculous. Okay. Why are we doing this?
You just got it.
I'm not looking for a viral moment. I'm looking for some honesty from you. You know better than this.
I have not
or maybe you don't know better than this. Keith, this is outrageous.
Keith, I have not gotten any honesty from the left,
we're
or quite frankly, a lot of the media.
About the left. We're talking about the President of the United States.
What is
his responsibility? Where does the buck stop, Rob?
I asked you a question before.
You don't
think
the questions here. Eric is the moderator. You won't even answer the question she asked.
Pose your question, Rob, and then let's
through the chair, may I ask a question? I asked you a question before. Do you think it's appropriate that Elizabeth Warren sent out a fundraising letter in the middle of this? Do you think it's appropriate
What does this have to do with the President of the United States?
Because
the
it was the
tone.
The
President supposed to set
my point
the tone.
To your question. Here's
and
my
he
point to
did.
Question.
He gave a speech in the Oval in the White House. He has
and then
gone
he went
to
out
Dayton.
And started tweeting about attacking people. He attacked
Barack
Obama.
Hold on 1 second, both of you.
Barack Obama and Hillary Clinton.
Hold on one second, because you each have a very important question to answer. First of all, Rob, putting aside Democrats, shouldn't the President of the United States set the tone he wants everyone else to follow? Period, full stop.
He did.
Except for then he didn't.
He did.
Rob, and then
he was viciously attacked by the left and the media, the nonstop.
Okay, so that's not really answering the question. But you also, Keith, have an important question to answer. Joe Biden, who is the front runner, right, came out today, and I played part of what he said, but he also said things like this, and I just want to play it quickly and ask you whether you think this is okay.
Our president has aligned himself with the darkest forces in this nation. We have a president with a toxic tongue who has publicly and unapologetically embraced a political strategy of hate, racism, and division. Our president has more in common with George Wallace than he does with George Washington. His incompetence, his immorality, his carnage stops with us.
He used the word carnage 4 days after the mass shooting, putting all those things together. Should Joe Biden have done that speech today on the day the president was going to visit victims?
I don't know. I'm not here to defend or criticize
come on,
Joe Biden.
You attacked me for not... The answer
but,
is no.
I'll give at least keep saying I don't know. That was more than you would say about Trump.
Let me just say this. I answered your question.
I'm not here to attack or defend Joe Biden, but I will say this. I think that...
It was wrong.
I'm not sure whether it's wrong or not, because I just heard that for the first time right now.
What else do you need to hear? It was inflammatory.
Well, I don't think that anything that Joe Biden said in the earlier remark about Donald Trump fanning the flames is inaccurate. And I don't see any lies in that part. But let me just tell you this. Donald Trump is the only president of the United States we have right now. It's not Elizabeth Warren. It's not Beto O'Rourke. It's not Joe Biden. It's not myself. It's not anybody else but Donald Trump. And the president has to set the tone. Barack Obama did that. George W. Bush did that. Every other president in my lifetime has tried to set the tone. Even when they were unfairly attacked, they tried to set the tone. This guy speaks with forked tongue. He gives one speech for 10 minutes, and then we're supposed to forget about the 4 years of lies and racism and xenophobia and bigotry that he's responsible for. That is not right.
The answer is no. It was inappropriate for them to be doing what they've been doing over the last 4 days. If they want to go on these attacks next week,
Rob,
go ahead.
Then it's also inappropriate for Donald Trump
He's
to release the campaign
responding
ad.
To
Donald
what
Trump
they
didn't start any of this.
But Rob, why does he respond? He went on Twitter today. By the way, after Sherrod Brown said it was good that he came to visit and the people were glad to see him. He criticized him on gun control. That's a policy dispute, okay?
Yeah, and I think what he should have said is, today's not the day. We're here in the hospital.
Why does the president have to respond to every time
The president tweets, I saw failed presidential candidate 0% Sherrod Brown and Mayor Whaley representing what took place inside
yes,
the hospital.
They did.
Okay, what they said took place inside the hospital is that people were very happy to see the president, that he was a comforter, and they were glad he was there. So I don't know what he takes issue with, Rob, but it's hopefully it wasn't that.
He takes issues, not the
Okay, hold on, hold on. No. Beto O'Rourke, Beto slams the president. Does the president need to come out and say he's now embarrassed by polling at 1% in the Democratic Party or by coming out on tape today and saying this?
You know, Joe is a pretty incompetent guy. I've watched his interviews, I've watched what he said and how he said it, and I wouldn't have rated him very high in the first place, but Joe Biden has truly lost his fastball, that I can tell you. My critics are political people, they're trying to make points, in many cases they're running for president and they're very low in the polls.
I mean, Rob, at the least, can you admit it's bizarre that he has to talk about polls so much? What does where people are polling in the Democratic Party have to do with anything right now?
Look, that was his response. And I've said these kind of things in the past, do I think he should have taken the bait and responded to these things? No, I don't. However, you know, the media and certainly the presidential candidates and the left has been criticizing him unfairly in many ways and attacking him. What if I called you a white nationalist, a segregationist? Are you going to sit there and take it?
What if you're spent 5.5 years lying about somebody's birth certificate?
You haven't created several
What if you spent 5.5 years lying about someone's birth certificate? Okay. He just took it. Barack Obama was a man. He was a president of the United States. He didn't respond to every stupid lie that Donald Trump put out there. This guy is irresponsible and reckless, and that's not the behavior we want from a president of the United States.
You
want
to have those fights? Have those fights. But these last 4 days, these last 4 days should be off limits, and the Democrats
have not made it off limits. No, you tell that to Donald Trump. Don't tell me what the Democrats are doing.
Julian Castro, you tell that to
Donald Trump. Donald Trump is the president of the United States.
And the list goes on.
None of those people are, and he needs to start acting like
it. As the president will point out, either none or one of them will be the president, but there is only one president right now.
Thank you very much.